everyone. Welcome to lesson 11, the last video, we hope, where you just have to watch me on a big screen. Hopefully after Easter, I'll be in person. Can't wait to see you all. But we're going to start with my favourite warm-up. We haven't done it this term. I think we might have done it before Christmas. And it's the deep and wide song. I'm going to remind you how it goes. It goes like this. Deep and wide, deep and wide, there's a river flowing deep and wide. Deep and wide, deep and wide, there's a river flowing deep and wide, deep and wide. Do you remember doing that one? I love it. I'll do it again. Join in if you think you can remember it. This is the action for deep. This is the action for wide. And then we've got our river flowing like this. Go on, I bet you can remember it. Here we go. Deep and wide. Deep and wide. There's a river flowing deep and wide. Deep and wide. Deep and wide. There's a river flowing deep and wide. Deep and wide. Right, I'm sure you've got that. So let's make it more fun. Let's take out, I'm going to have to guess because obviously you're not there to help here. So let's take out wide. Move wide out of the song and all you can do is the action. Not even a, remember? No sound at all. No wide. Here we go. Off we go. Deep and deep and there's a river flowing deep and deep and deep and there's a river flowing deep and deep and. Did you get it? Right, what should we miss out now? River. No river. So no wide and no river. No wide, no river. No wide, no river. Here we go. Deep and deep and there's a flowing deep and deep and deep and there's a flowing deep and deep and. I bet somebody did it. I bet somebody said wide at the end. Okay, now we're going to take out, let's take out deep. So now there's no deep, no wide, no river. Here we go. And there's a flowing and there's a flowing and I bet I'm winning. Bet I'm winning. Okay. No deep, no wide, no river, no flowing. No flowing. So that all we've got is and. Don't forget to sing the and. And don't forget the there's a. Okay, here we go. Off we go. And there's a. And there's a. And there we go. And if of course you've got all that wrong, then just go back and have another go. It's all good stuff. Now, if you remember at the end of last week's video, I said I would like to finish off this term by going back over some of the songs and the pieces that we've learnt throughout the term. And I'm going to start with One Man Went to Mow. Before we remember the song, let's remember the chords. So there were two chords. They were the chord of F and the chord of C7. Don't panic. I'm going to show you now what those two chords are. F, remember. If I call string number 4 nearest the floor, we'll go up to string number 3 with our first finger in the first fret like that. String number one then is nearest your face. You're going to take your second finger and put it in the second fret of the string number one. So when you play those four strings together, you've got that. So extreme close up, you should have something like that. Second finger, second fret, string number one. First finger, first fret, string number three. So let's just get our F chord, plus remind yourselves, get the F chord sounding nice like that, plus nice and firmly. Don't forget your beak there, strumming over where the neck of your ukulele meets the body. Okay, that's your F chord. C7 was so easy, watch this. You don't need your second, so you take that off, and you simply slide your first down to string number four. Just a one finger chord. It's really easy. Come on, you can do that with me now. The trickier bit is getting back to the F. So you moved your first finger up one, and then dive for that top string like that. So just give yourself a second or two. Just going backwards and forwards between those two chords. Just make sure you can do it nice and quickly. If you need to stop here, just to remind yourselves, you can. But those are the two chords that you're going to need. Okay. So, the song. Shall I sing it to you? Shall I remind you of it? It went like this. One man went to mow a meadow. One man and his French papa. Poodle, pup, and a bone for his dog, and a bottle of pop. Say it with me. Here we go. French Pomeranian, poodle, pup, and a bone for his dog, and a bottle of pop. And again, just a little bit faster. French Pomeranian, poodle, pup, and a bone for his dog, and a bottle of pop. And again, just a little bit faster. French Pomeranian, poodle, pup, and a bone for his dog, and a bottle of pop. French Pomeranian, poodle, pup, and a bone for his dog, and a bottle of pop. That's about as fast as we need to do it. Okay, right then, here's how we fit the singing with the playing. F chord to start off with. And listen to when I change to a C7 chord. One man went to mow a meadow. One man and his French Pomeranian went to mow a meadow. So every time we get to the word meadow, you swap from one chord to the other. So if we're on an F chord, you swap to a C7 when we sing meadow. If you're on a C7 chord, you swap to an F chord when the next meadow comes along. Now the strumming pattern, all I'm doing is down, up, down, down, up, down, down, up, down. If that's too hard for you, don't worry about it. You could just do some downs to the beat, okay? Still remembering to change on the meadow like that. And if that's too hard, just take out a note every other beat. So it's one, two. You just keep it as simple or as tricky as you like. It's entirely up to you. Let's just get those changes on the meadow, okay? Okay, I'll start us off. Ready, steady, here we go. One man went to mow a meadow. One man and his French Pomeranian poodle pup and a bone for his dog and a bottle of pop. Went to mow a meadow. I like to hit my ukulele after I've done pop. Here we go. Two men went to mow a meadow. Two men, one man and his French Pomeranian poodle pup and a bone for his dog and a bottle of pop. The next piece that we're going to remember is how we learnt the okey-cokey. Now, do you remember it wasn't a chord piece? We were actually playing the melody and it needed four notes. And I'm going to remind you what those notes were. So the first note was the note C, not the chord C. So you don't play all four strings. You just play the top string, string number four nearest the floor. And that, with your third finger on, will give you the C. So it's just one note and one finger, just your thumb down here, look, C. Then we also needed a B. Now, to swap C to B, you did that. So you put your second finger on the second fret. Okay, same string. Still on the same string, lift all of your fingers off. So you've just got the A string sounding by itself. And then the fourth note that you needed was crossing over to string number three, third finger fret three, and that gave you the note G, not the G chord, just the G. So you've got to pick out the third string here and just play that string with your third finger on the fret. So you don't need the other notes of the chord. So those notes again were C, B, A, and G. Okay? And here's how the pattern went. You played on the C three times. C, C, C. As if you're singing, you put your left arm in. Then you do it again. Left arm out. So it's three times. Then you play it four times. In, out, in, out. So it's all on the note C. C, 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 C. Then you move down to a B. B, B, B. So let's do that little bit together first. Find your C, a set of three, a set of three, and a set of four. Ready? Steady? Here we go. So it's a one, two, three, a one, two, three, a one, two, three, four, and move it down. Okay? One more time. Here we go. So it's a C, 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 a C, 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 a C, 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 a B, B, B. Now you stay on the B. B, 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 B. So it's another two sets of three. So that's the bit that goes, you do the okey-cokey and you turn around. Okay, two sets of three. Let's go from the beginning up as far as there. Find your C again. Here we go. So it was three. Two more of those. Two, 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 a two, two, two. And the hardest bit, but the best bit, is where you go, that's what it's all about. And that's where you climb up G, A, B, C. We'll do two G's. That's what it's all about. G, G, A, B, C. Do that again. Find your G's. So you're on the third string, third fret. Two of those, cross over and climb up there. G, G, A, B, C. Have a go with me, find your G. Ready, steady, here we go. It's G, G, A, B, C. If you needed to stop it there and practice, this is a good point. But if you're ready, we'll do it all the way through. Are you ready then with your third finger? Ready, steady, here we go. So it's a C, 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 a C, 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 a C, 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 a B, 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 a B, 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 B. Now climb up, a G, G, A, B, C. Right, we're going to do it with the music. You play it through twice, and after you've played it, you do your... Okay, good. And then you do it again, okay? So, here we go. One, two, three, four, and B, 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 B like to play it through again. Change to B's now. And again. B, 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 B. Now land on your third finger and climb up. All together now. I'd like us to remember is another piece that used two chords, and that was the Drunken Sailor. And I'm going to remind you which two chords there were now. So first of all, a chord that we learned way back in the first term, and that was A minor. Let me remind you how A minor goes. Now, when I was with you, you would have might have remembered me saying A minor. String number one, that's the one nearest to your face. Second fret with your second finger like that. That's also the start of the F chord, if you remember. Let me just put your second finger down there. First finger. But I'm going to just mix it up just a little bit and ask you to put, instead of your second finger on the second fret, I want you to put your first finger on the second fret. It makes the same sound. Exactly the same sound, but the reason that you're going to use that finger instead of your second is because of the other chord that we need, which is the G chord. Now, if your first finger is in the second fret, it's nearly there to get ready for the G chord. It's nearly on the G chord already. Here's what you do. The first thing you're going to do is you're going to bring your first finger, move it away from your face by one string. So now it's sitting in the second fret of the second string. Okay. Then, do you remember how we used our third finger for our okie kokie? And that went in the third fret of the third string. So that's ready to plonk down. And your middle finger now, your second finger, is just going to sit also on the second fret, but on the A string. So those are three notes that you've got to place your fingers on. Let's do it again slowly. A minor, you're going to play with your first finger on the second fret. String number one nearest to your face. To get to G, slide that down by one string. Add your third finger to string number three, and string number four nearest the floor, second finger, second fret. Extreme close up. There we have it. There's my first finger, it slid down. Let's get that strap out of the way. First finger slid down, third finger's gone down, second finger's gone down. Okay, so that is your G chord. And the way you do it is you simply have to go from A and you go to G. So if you really, really just cannot get that G chord, then I will give you a get out clause. You can, if you really must, just play the note G on its own. So you could go from an A minor chord, I'm sure you can play the chord, to a G on its own if you needed to. Okay. Let me remind you how the whole thing went while you watch, and then you can join in afterwards. So we start on an A minor chord. We don't sing at the beginning, we just play. G majors. two of those. And two of those. Let's pause there. So did you remember that? Think in sets of four. Four A minor. Now if you want to do G chord, you can. If you just want to play the G, then you can just play your four Gs. It's up to you. But then you go back to your A minor. Play all four strings for that. Then it's a set of two. One, two, and one, two. Okay? Then there's a gap in the music. You'll have time to put your ukuleles down on your desks, and then you sing. And we went something like a sort of a sailor's, what shall we do with a drunken sailor? Do you remember doing this? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? What shall we do with a drunken sailor? A lie in the morning. Do you remember all of that? Then it was hooray and up she rises. And this is where you pull on the rope. Hooray and up she rises. Change sides. Hooray and up she rises. Hooray and up she rises. A lie in the morning. So that's come back to you, hasn't it? Shall we do it all the way through then? Yeah, why not find your A minor chord now with me? Get set up, so get your ukuleles again. Find your A minor chord, first finger, second fret. And let's see, we play first, and you put your ukuleles down, and we sing. Always think in sets of four. Was a piece that used chords. Then we introduced a new note to our collection. For the okey-cokey, you needed G and A and B and C. Do you remember that new note that we introduced? I think it was only the last week or the week before. And it was tricky because you needed to stretch out your pinky finger onto the fifth fret of the fourth string. So you can count with me. One, two, three, four, five. Mine's got a dot on it, and I wondered if yours had, if you remember. And that's where your pinky goes. Now your pinky is of course the weakest of all your fingers. And of course you're playing it with your left hand. So the pinky on your left hand, unless you're left-handed, is going to be the weakest of all of your 10 fingers. So this might struggle a little bit. But what you're really going to try and do is go for that fifth fret. You will have to miss out that fret there. So you've got this sort of huge gap. Although your ukuleles are smaller than mine, so it might not be too much of a stretch. And that new note was the note D. So we had a G, an A, a B, a C, and a D.
don't know which song that went with. That's right. It was Once a Man Fell in a Well. The first three lines were the same. Once a man fell in a well. So it just climbs up. Second line, splish, splash, splosh, he sounded. That climbs up with just two A's, two D's at the top. Third line was the same. If he had not fallen in. Now the last line was different. Do you remember how? Yes. It was backwards. So you go from four down to three. You can do that face. Two. Open A and cross over to your G. So let's practice that together now. And then I'm going to cheat a little bit and I'm going to slot in the same video clips that we did before when we did it in a set of two and a set of three. So you may remember which groups you are in. It's just a bit more further practices, if you like. So first of all, let's all play the tune together. Are you ready? Here we go. G, A, B, C. Stretch it out. One, two, three. Back to your G. Climb up. Stretch it out. Two of them. Back to your G. Climb up. Now backwards. Take that third down. Two, open, and three. Okay. So the next clip you'll see will be in two groups. So you decide which half you want to be, half group one or group two, and just follow the correct side of the screen. Do you remember doing that? And of course, you can take it one step further, split yourself into groups of three, and have a go in the next clip in groups of three. Right, the last song that we're going to remind ourselves of to finish off this lesson is The Lion Sleeps Tonight. It's probably the hardest one of all because it used three chords and it kept going backwards and forwards between them. And of course, there's the words to learn as well. You might still have those sheets handy. If you do, now might be a good time to give them out. Let me remind you what you need to do with the chords. So the three different, my cat's come to annoy me. The three different chords are the C chord, okay? We've been doing that, that's fine. We're going to need an F chord, talked about that right at the beginning. You'll go back to your C chord, and then you'll drop onto your G chord. And again, if you're still struggling with your G, just use your third finger and play a single note. And the order, C, F, C, G. Okay. This is, so I've just got to just, this is Matilda, and she's getting in the way again. So I'm going to get rid of Matilda, just going to throw her away. Go on, Matilda, out you go. And I'll carry on. So it was a C, it was an F, it was a C, and it was either the G chord, or if you can't manage the whole chord, just play a G on its own, okay? So we'll hear an introduction, and then we'll play along with our chord sequence. Then we will sing the verses. We'll sing the verse. So it's in the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. Like that, sing that. And then you'll play along with the chorus bit. And then the second verse is, if you've got the words, it was in the village, the peaceful village, the lion sleeps tonight. In the village, the quiet village, the lion sleeps tonight. So then we play again. After we've sung, we'll play again. There's a little bit of an extended playing going on, so just keep playing until I tell you to stop. Then the third verse comes along, and it's hush, my darling, don't fear, my darling, the lion sleeps tonight. Have you got this on your sheets? Hush, my darling, don't fear, my darling, the lion sleeps tonight. And then, I don't know, we might even sing, shall we see how it goes? If it all goes wrong, we can just do it again, can't we? Right, get your C chord ready. So just one stroke on each chord, the C first, F, C, G, and repeat it, C, F, C, G. In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. Ready to play? It's a C, a F, a C, and a G. And the same again, a C, F, C. The lion sleeps tonight. In the village, the quiet village, the lion sleeps tonight. C chord, F, C, same again, it's C. Let's keep playing. Another C. We've been through such a lot of stuff this lesson, and that's not everything that we've done. Don't forget those 12 bar blues that we did, and the jazz on three notes really kept you busy, and I do hope you've enjoyed it and you've improved, and I can't wait to get into school with you and see just how you've done. So keep practicing, really be prepared to impress me back in April when I come back, and take care, have a lovely Easter holiday, and I'll see you all soon.